Hello everyone, it's Vicky, and I'm here today with a really fun video and a video that many of you requested to see. I had shown my Chic Sparrow in the American Deluxe in Sweet Pea. It's this beautiful, vibrant pink. I guess it's a hot pink. It's just stunning. It's beautiful. I love it. And many of you, when I showed this to you, wanted to see what was inside. I can totally and completely understand why people want to see what's inside. I always look for those videos as well. And it's for inspiration. You know, you're kind of wanting to know, what in the world do you fill these beautiful notebooks with? I always like that too. I want to know, you know, how people are filling their notebooks. How are they organizing their days? What are they doing? It's just a great way to stay inspired and to stay in touch with your beautiful traveler's notebook. I absolutely adore this, and this one happens to speak to me in a very creative way. And it's mainly because of the color. It's just very fun, it's very bright, and anytime I pick it up, I don't want to do business in it, I want to do fun stuff in it. And so I'm still kind of working on what I'm actually going to be putting in here. I think I'm going to take out one of the inserts that's in here and put it in another one, but my like brown colored ones, the black ones, those to me speak in more of a business sense rather than a kind of like fun and colorful and this is so girly, and it speaks to me in that way. That's how I work. That's how my brain works. It doesn't need to work that way for you. I'm just sharing that with you because I have a couple and I plan to show you my different Midoris and how I use them, and that's why I'm prefacing with that, is that it speaks to me in a creative, fun, girly way. Just like certain planners speak to me in certain ways, this one speaks to me in a fun and creative way. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn you around and show you guys what is inside of this one, and then I'm also going to show you guys my finished Lister's Got a List for April, the insert that I completed for this. I do want to stress this to you, that if you're someone who struggles with doing journaling, using something like this challenge or using any type of art prompts like from a book or you know, from a YouTube video or anything like that, anytime you're using something like that, it's going to really help you to become a better journaler or a better, you know, whatever you want to become, better creative person. Using prompts like that to get you going can really help you become that, because if it doesn't come to you naturally, where you can just sit down with a piece of paper and a pen and just flows out of you, having these prompts can help that. It'll help, you know, your that part of your brain, like any other kind of muscle, it's going to help work that up, and it's really, you'll get maybe to the point where you won't need prompts, or you're going to be somebody who always needs prompts. But I got to say, this challenge is easy. It's something you can do each and every single day, and it helps bring up memories. It helps jog memories. It helps you in that part of your brain if that's something you're striving to do. So I just want to say that, and I will show you guys this even though I pulled it out of here because the May one is inside of here. So let me turn you guys around so you can see what's inside. Alright, so here is my April's Lister's Got a List. If you guys hear panting, that's Hank. It's really hot today and he's in here. He insisted on coming up here. So this is Corey's challenge, if you aren't familiar with it. It's called, you know, Lister's Got a List, and this is for April, so I just kind of went with like a fairly girly theme. You know, sometimes I'm inspired by that, sometimes I'm a little more, you know, just all different. But for this one, I kind of went with, you know, a journal card here, and then these stickers are from the Target Dollar Bin. This is from Project Life that had like a gold foil type of a kit, and that's from the same kit as well. I am still maybe deciding on if I want to decorate this page. I haven't completely decided yet. And then I always like having the prompts in the front of the insert. And the reason for that is because that's where I reference it. So if I had it in my planner or anything like that, I don't know. I just prefer having it in this book. You could definitely have it in your planner if you prefer. I just happen to have it in the front of my insert. So again, here's what's great. You know, these prompts, just to go back to this, are really fun, and they're really great to kind of get you motivated to journal or to be creative or color or cut or paste or do whatever you'd like to do. And you know, some of the things to highlight in here, like favorite songs of all time, it really brought me down memory lane. I went into my iTunes and I kind of looked at like my most playlist, my phobias. You know, that wasn't something really easy to visit, but again, it, you know, it kind of pushes your body boundaries. It pushes you to think outside of, you know, dear diary, this is what I did today. It kind of pushes you past that. Your best books I have read, that really made me sit down and think about it. It made me go down to Instagram and see, you know, are there books on there that people have mentioned that, like, oh yeah, that's something I really loved. You know, people I most admire and why. That really, like, helps you to be grateful and think about, you know, who am I grateful to have known in my life, or someone that I've, you know, seen on television or whatever it may be. But it's a great way to kind of push your boundaries. So just to show you, I have Instagram some of these, and again, the pages change, and you know, you can play with all sorts of different kind of ephemera, which are these little guys, so you can kind of see the colors. I'm not going to read everything, you guys. You can always, like, pause the screen and look through things, because this video would take forever. But you know, I play with stamps. I usually use the Project Life card just to kind of get through some of those stickers. I really liked using in through here, and I liked the idea of using the journal cards to write on. It's just, it makes it easier to kind of write on them. I really do like using the stamps in here, and I did some drawing with fountain pen in here, and again, some stamps. And then I was using these stickers for the dates, so like April 7th and 8th, I was using that. These were like favorite washies, so I had some washies on there. I decided to put a Polaroid in, which was for, I think this was part of the washi. Yeah, part of the favorite washi. So I just took a picture of my notebook with all the washi tapes. And then I started using like the labels. I was using some stamp ink for kind of like just staining it a little bit. And then here's a bunch of stamps, post-its. Here I used just, you know, scrap paper on the back. These were some Halloween stickers that I had because I'm scared of spiders, and this was kind of the phobias. Anything that I have in my, like, scrap box, I pull that out, which is great for this type of stuff, because you can just stick whatever you want. As you guys can see, there's no rhyme or reason. There's a whole bunch of colors. There's washi, you know, there's stickers. I found these at Meijer for, like, a major discount, these pink stickers, and so I started using those and stamping the dates on there. Again, just using scrap paper, scrap ephemera. Some of the stuff you guys send me, this is from Happy Scrappy, her post-it, which is fantastic quality, by the way. One of the best post-its I've ever used, I have to say. You know, I had these butterfly ephemera that I hadn't used in years, and so I started using those. Again, doing some drawing and some washi tape in here. And this is a really funny stamp. I like that finger pointing. And this was a stamp down here as well. Some washi tape down here at the bottom. Some of them are brighter and more filled up than others. Like, these are fairly simple. And, you know, that's the great thing about this, is you can just kind of do whatever you want to. You know, here I kind of, like, lost my steam with drawing out all the different kinds of candy that I loved as a kid. So I just left it alone. You know, if you don't feel like doing something, just leave it alone. Here, you know, I just kind of started making it real busy with the paper and the ephemera, and then decided to not do as much writing and just kind of leave it at that. Here I just used some stamps, and I don't know if it shows up on the viewfinder. It looks really faded, but I just wanted to kind of keep it muted towards the end here. So it started off, you know, super bright and lots of stuff, to more of kind of, you know, keeping it nice and muted and focusing more, like, on the backs of the pages. So I started kind of using more craft paper, like I did here. I was using the craft paper. This is a post-it note from Target that I use. Again, some ephemera, some stickers. Then here I just went on the computer and printed out a whole bunch of, like, board game pictures that I loved, because the prompt was for board games that I loved as a kid. And this was, you know, what I love about myself. So this is from Mrs. Brimble's. This is, like, one of the, when she sends her box, she writes, like, a little info on the back. And so I kind of stuck that in there because I like the colors of it. And that's the end. So there's a couple of pages that are left that I could fill. I haven't decided quite yet, but that's this, this was for April. And then to kind of show you guys the Midori itself, this is, again, the American Deluxe and Sweet Pea. So I love these pockets. I think they're great. Sometimes the Project Life cards fit in the back here. They don't fit in these smaller slots, but the back one here is, like, a large pocket. So I have those mainly for the Lister's Got a List, because that's something that I kind of just like having With me in these pockets, but I love the stitching on these. I think she did a really fantastic job. This cute little paper clip that's up at the top here was in one of the Mrs. Brimble's boxes, and I just like it. Again, this speaks to me in a very creative way, and so I like to keep it very creative. Again, I used just some Project Life cards, and this is for the May Lister's Got a List, and I'm using the yellow paper house insert, and I believe this is in the sea glass with the little tiny dot grid. I put in Corey's list here for the month of May because I love having that as a reference. And I think I'm actually behind a few days in here, but I do have the first, second, and I think this is the third. So I'm a few days behind, but that's what's really nice about the weekends is you can kind of catch up on things. So I love the fact that the pages are colored. You can see they kind of are... they're all kind of like complementary colors, and so I love using that. So just some washi tape, some ephemera, post-its, or you know, the Project Life cards kind of act as a great source to write on. So that's kind of what that book is. This book is going to be dedicated to. And then in the second book, I just used craft paper and I just covered an insert book. This is the actual like Midori. I think this is the lightweight Midori insert. And I just get craft paper. This is craft paper and I just drew it with a pen. I just like outlined and drew it with a pen. And this is like a bullet journal. I started keeping the months in here and I might go back to it. I stopped for a little while, but I think I might go back to it because I liked having the months there. But it's just basic, like a brain dump type of a mechanism that I do in here. I might switch this out and put it into my one from Cody instead of keeping it in here, just because this doesn't speak to me in necessarily a creative way. So I might transfer it over into the one from Cody. Then I just have one of these pockets, and there's just like extra Polaroid pictures that I printed out for myself and put them here to have. This is for books. I just use, again, construction paper. I'm sorry, scrap paper that I had that had little rulers on there that I thought was cute for books. And in here I put things that you guys recommend. So like books to be read, I have a title there. So what you guys recommend. And then I have books after I'm done reading them or while I'm reading them, I put notes in here. And then this is the other side of the pocket. These are just the templates for bows that Alexis, aka Miss Trenchcoat, she has like a template on her blog. And so I just have that in here in case I ever want to make the little bow clips, which I have a few of them. I just don't have them in here. And then I have projects in here. And the reason why projects is in here creative for the kind of like creative thing is because a lot of times I am drawing out things in here. Like this is drawing out curtains that I want to do. This is like kitchen table that I want to repaint the surface of it. So it does speak to me in a relatively creative format. And so that's why I kind of keep it that way, you know. So, you know, things I'm working out, any kind of ideas. And then I have like an area back here for wish lists to like jot down things that I may want. And then I just, this is from A Girl of All Works, like the one that says projects. These tabs are just post-its, actually, that just stick out. And then this I laminated and cut myself. So, and then same goes for these. The February and January, those are from Girl of All Works. And these guys I just printed from like Microsoft Word, and I just laminated them. And I just like how they stick out, and the colors of them just kind of speak creatively to me. And then on the back is just like this big pocket. I don't have anything in there. This normally houses my Twisby is in here, but I was using it for something this morning, so it's not in there right now. But usually my white and rose gold Twisby is always attached to this one. They just complement each other really nicely. So that is the inside of this Midori, my ChicSparrow. So I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I'll let you know about my other Midoris and kind of what I have in there as well. I love watching your videos if you guys post them on these. I always try and scour the internet on these. Oh, and another question that I got was, does this scuff easily? I haven't gotten it to scuff. There is a little bit of glue on here, and that's just my fault from working with it, but I don't actually have any like scratches on here. So I've had it for a few weeks just to show you guys. It's pretty smooth. That's just paper that was on there. It's not a scratch, but this would be pretty hard to scratch. I don't imagine, unless you actually like took something to it and like, you know, scraped it against it, but it doesn't scratch very easily because I don't think it's that type of a leather. So I had a few questions on that. But that's everything. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you again soon. Take care. Bye-bye.